Childhood days is a time for learning, playing, exploring, and enjoying the perks of being a child. But not all children enjoy that. Some of them are working in sites where they're building buildings, they carry cement, they carry bricks. Some children are working in tea shops, some are working in mechanical shop. They work so hard, they work long hours, about 12 to 13 hours a day. Some are working in cycle shops. Some children are working in fireworks, where they make firecrackers. Some are working in matchbox factory. Some are working in mechanic shop. Some children are working in automobile mechanic shops. You may be wondering, are these children all happy here? They are not happy. Why? Because they don't get enough rest. They're not studying. They cannot read. They cannot write. They feel so bad. So what is happening now? We can see that in some places, the NGOs have rescued some children, like this little boy who was 14 years old and he was working in a mine, working 13 hours a day. He was rescued by them and he went back to school to study. He was so happy. And he went back to his village and he said, "My humble plea is, educate your children or your next generation will suffer." So all the people started to think about it. Yes, we have to educate our children. Now many of them have left education is because of their family environment. Now we see another gay boy who was 15 years old. He was working in a restaurant, serving food, 10 hours, 12 hours. He wanted to study, but what is the use? His family was so big. His father was not able to go out to work and he found it very difficult. He had 5 sisters who used to work in houses as maids, but still that money was not enough. So that is why he had to go to a restaurant to work. But there also an NGO came and rescued him. You know, children get good skills of computer, how to work on the computer he learned. And then he started also studying by distant education and he's coming up in life. What great joy these children are having when they know that they have the right to study, the right to enjoy life. Here there's another organization which is called as Goodweave Organization. This Goodweave Organization was started in 1995 by Mr. Kailash Satyarthi. Okay, he is a children's rights activist and Nobel Peace Prize winner. He started this organization and he donated money for the education of children who are having this problem where their families are not able to support, and he doesn't allow children to work in his company. So in this way, he encouraged children to go and study. So let us try to see how we can stop child labor. You children can do it. You can be the change which you want. You can see the children go back to school and study. Now you may be thinking, so what? So we should not do any work at home? See, your parents help you to study. So you should in turn help your parents. You should help your parents in cleaning your cars, in doing the work in the kitchen. You should help your parents in so many ways, in cleaning up your dirty clothes, putting in the washing machine, or helping it to dry, helping mommy to clean the house, to put the toys back. It is your responsibility. So you have to work with your parents. See, you can help your parents to water your garden, to clean up the window pane. So it is your responsibility. So what happens is that when you do like this, you get into a culture where you know what you need to. Nobody has to dictate it to you. You know when something is wrong, when the place is not clean, how to clean it. And this will help you when you grow up When you become a professional, you'll know how to help your colleague. You'll know what your boss requires, even before he says. So you'll be a good worker. So children, this should be your dream. That you want every child in your country, India, to have a right to study. You can, I can, and I will. So keep dreaming, children. When you keep dreaming and start working at it, one day you will be a tool to reach out to many in this world.
I got rights, you got rights,
we've all got rights, we've all got rights.
Gotta have a home, gotta be well fed, have a place to learn and rest your head.
We've all got rights, we've all got rights.
Gotta have a say, gotta raise a view, have a place to play, express a view.
We've all got rights, we've all got rights.
Gotta know your name, get the doctor's cure, don't get pushed around anymore.
We've all got rights,
shift abroad, you can join the club, not be ignored.
We've all got rights, we've all got rights.
Gotta know your mom,
know your mom.
Gotta watch TV,
watch TV.
Gotta know the law,
know the law.
'Cause you and me,
you and me.
We've all got rights,
rights.
We've all got rights. We've